Yo mates, let's talk about Honor of Kings builds, hero items, arcana and summoners. We're going to be breaking down hero builds today, looking into build options, ideal paths and the specific items in detail, all in English, for us to finally understand this popular Chinese game. I do also have hero skills and gameplay breakdowns if you're looking for that. YouTube playlist links are in the descriptions below. Okay, so today's hero is Liu Shan. In my opinion, he's probably the top 3 support right now, in contention as the best, alongside Neil Mo. He's creeping up to about 53% win rate, with a 19% playing rate. Now that's extremely high. Liu Shan suits the current meta really well right now, because the meta is fast paced, there's a lot of fights early, especially in mid lane and the river, and there's a lot of roaming in the early game too. Now Liu Shan shines with that, with his first two skills. They offer two stuns for control, knockup, and increases movement speed. Also his passive disables towers, but I especially want to emphasize on his skill 1. It provides move speed, a shield, and his next basic attack is a stun knockup. So that means with your arcana and your item build, you want to really improve on your skill 1 usage. So you're going to be wanting to focus on cooldown, move speed, and lastly attack speed and HP. It's mostly so you can use your skill 1 to harass and constantly control the game. Before we get into specific items in the build, let's quickly go over the summoners and arcana. Now, with summoners, there's mainly two that a lot of Liu Shans use, and I want to just briefly go over interference, but I mainly want to talk about flash. Now, interference, of course, it disables towers, either your own tower or the enemy tower, so you can disable and tower dive or your tower to save. But I think that's a summoner that's used by Liu Shan around 2 seasons ago, when the meta was a bit slower. Now, when the meta is much faster, I actually prefer flash. Okay, arcana. First is reds. I recommend Fate. Gives attack speed, maximum health, and physical defense. A red arcana that really suits Liu Shan. So with Liu Shan, like I said before, you want to focus on cooldown, and then move speed, and lastly the stats of HP. Now with blue arcana, you're gonna mostly want to get Hunter. It gives you move speed and attack speed. Now if you chuck 10 on it, you get 10% move speed. That's massive for the early game. If you're afraid of getting bursted too much, then you can have a combination of Hunter and some Harmony. Now Harmony gives you some move speed, just 0.4 per Harmony, but you get max health and health regeneration. I like to use this if there's a lot of burst, especially if the jungler, mid, and support combo of the enemy team, because you're going to be fighting against them the most for the first 10 minutes of the game. Any burst jungler with heavy engage tank supports, then grab some Harmony, it's a good idea. Now with green arcana, most of the time I go with 10 times facility. It gives cooldown reduction, a nice chunk, and max health. That's a great combination for Liu Shan in my opinion. Okay, so Liu Shan's item build. Your core first 3 are Polar Shadow support item, resistance boots, frost storm. Usually 75% of your game should end after building these 3. After that you're going to be building magic resists, because around 10 to 15 minutes is when team fights start and magic damage starts to hurt. Then armor. Near end game is when ADCs become online now in this meta. They become online really slow now, that's why they're so weak. Last item is, depending on what you need, could be more armor, general purpose shield, or more HP to cover more damage. Let's go into detail now of each item. Polar Shadow support item gives cooldown and attack speed to surrounding allies and to yourself. Now 10% cooldown is massive for Liu Shan. You're gonna be wanting 40% cooldown, which you'll get with this build. To really rotate around your skills, skill 1, skill 2, you want to keep spamming your skill 1. That's why you want maximum cooldown from your build. Next onto the boots. Resistance boots is important because you usually want to go in head first as Liu Shan, so you need the crowd control reduction. Frost Storm, cooldown reduction, mana, and passive. On losing 10% HP, you deal magic damage around you. Now Frost Storm is amazing on Liu Shan, because as soon as you jump onto the enemy mage or the ADC, they're 100% gonna deal more than 10% damage to you. And with your skill rotations, you're gonna be unleashing damage on them plus the Frost Storm damage and killing them if you can find them isolated. So your main aim as Liu Shan in the mid to end game is finding the mage and ADC by themselves and taking them down early. Moving on to magic resist, you have two options here, the Witch's Cloak or the Guardian of Eternal Nights. Now the Witch's Cloak gives spell defense, maximum life, and healing back every 5 seconds, plus a passive where immediately after battle, you get a shield that absorbs magic damage. Guardian of Eternal Night, however, 360 spell defense, 1000 maximum life, and the passive is when receiving damage of more than 30% of maximum life, you regain health back in the next 3 seconds. You want to pick Guardian of Eternal Night when you're up against burst damage, and Witch's Click when you're versing a bit more sustained magic damage. Next up is armor. It's either Thornmail or Ominous Sign. Now Thornmail, as soon as you receive physical damage, you will be releasing magic damage back to enemies, either to the enemy that has inflicted it on you, you release more magic damage surrounding you. So you want Thornmail when you're versing burst melee assassins. As soon as they jump onto you, you're going to be releasing damage back to. Now Ominous Sign, you're going to be reducing the attacker's attack speed by 30% and movement speed by 15%. Now this is great if you're versing ADs or any damage that they're relying on attack speed, let's say a Lu Ban or Ho Yi, etc. You want Thornmail and usually when enemies are either grouped up or they're jumping on you. Ominous Signs when they're relying on attack speed to kill you from far away. So your final item, I usually like to choose either Thornmail or Ominous Sign, whichever that I didn't pick as my fourth item, or go with Ice Guard's Grip or Overlord Armor. Overlord Armor is a great general armor which gives you massive amounts of health, so you can just tank up any damage. So if you don't want to think about it, just grab Overlord's armor. Now Ice Guard's Grip is very interesting. It's a jack of all trades. It gives you health, mana, cooldown reduction, physical defense, and physical attack. And also it gives you a passive that empowers your next basic attack. Now if you want to do more damage as Liu Shan in the end game and you're not trusting your allies to do any damage, grab this one. It will help a little bit, I hope. So there you have it, Liu Shan's support CDR build for maximum action. I am also doing two new series. First is Hero Skills Breakdowns, where we look at the full English translated skills, also showing some combos, tips, anything related to the skills on a hero, and Gameplay Breakdowns, where I watch a game on a hero and comment on things like builds, skills, macro, matchups, all that good stuff. So that's all for this video, mate. Remember, drop a like and subscribe to see more English Honor of Kings content. Hopefully daily. Hopefully.
Hey!